So today I will continue with the same topic, general method of preparation. In this case, in case of aldehyde, that is common method, aldehydes and ketones. Okay. Do you remember the first common method was oxidation reaction? Oxidation reaction, that is oxidation of alcohol. Today I will give you few questions related to each and every topic. First of all, questions. First question is, if I write CH3, CH2, CH2, OH, listen carefully, K2Cr2O7 plus H2SO4, then find out the product A. If I write here CH3, CH2, CH2, OH, and here is Corey's reagent, find out the product A. Look at what I am telling. The third one is, PCC, find out the product. Now wait for a moment, I am moving here. Question number 2, write all the types of reagent which favors the oxidation of 1 degree or 2 degree or allylic or benzylic alcohol. Do you remember all this? In JEE Main, there was a question from this topic, that is the type of reagent which is used in oxidation. We'll discuss. Wait for a moment. Now next one. This is another method of preparation. By using gem dihalides, by using geminal dihalides. If I write here CS3, clear to you friend, then CH, wait for a moment, CH3CHCl2 and treated with aqueous KOH. What will happen in this case? This one is geminal dihalide, first one. Second one is, if I write CS3, then wait for a moment. First of all, we will do this, then we will discuss second one. Okay. Now, these are the question. Now tell me what will happen in this case. First of all, these are the common method I am talking about. Look at, if there is 1 degree alcohol and in presence of K2Cr2O7 plus H2SO4, what will happen? It will form aldehyde. Listen carefully. Remember this? But as we know, there is a presence of water, so further oxidation take place and it will be converted to carboxylic acid if there is no controlled oxidation. So the here the main product is carboxylic acid, not aldehyde, unless mentioned, that is controlled oxidation. Now look at here, if there is a Korea's reagent, then 1 degree alcohol will be converted to aldehyde, but it will restrict the further oxidation of aldehyde into acid. What is the reason behind it? Because it contains anhydrous situation. There is no presence of water, so aldehyde will not form aldehyde hydrate. And further treatment with H2CrO4, it converts to acid. But there is no such possibility in case of Corey's reagent, in case of Collins reagent. Clear friend, look at, in here A is acid and here A is aldehyde. Clear? Now next one, what will happen? That is PCC, and in this case it will not change the condition of double bond, only convert OH into ketonic group. That is clear friend, this is the product in this case. Now let's move here. Write all the type of reagent which favor the oxidation of 1 degree or 2 degree or allylic or benzylic. Do you remember this? Collins reagent, Corey's reagent, PDC, K2Cr2O7 plus H2SO4 for allylic and benzylic is a good one. Good reagent is John's reagent and active MnO2. Clear? These are the questions from JE mains. One question from JE mains was were asked from this topic. Now next is, by using geminal dihalides. What do you mean by geminal dihalides, friend? This one is link. Now what will happen in this case? When it is treated with aqueous KOH, now look at, it can be written like this, Here is Cl, clear? Now when treatment with aqueous KOH, then what will happen in this case? It will release Cl, it will release Cl, and there is an addition of like this, CH3, here is C, put here OH, put here OH, and here is H. Now this one is unstable, and further the removal of H2O take place. If the removal of H2O take place, then what will happen in this case? It forms, look at, CH3CHO. This one is acetaldehyde. This is the another method of preparation of ketone as well as aldehyde. Clear to you? Now there is a removal of 2 moles of KCl take place. Now wait for a moment, I'm moving here friend. Now what will happen? The next one, same second part. If I put CH3C, then CH3, put here Cl and put here Cl. Now again treatment with aqueous KOH, Do not use alcoholic KOH. Do you know what will happen? It will change, convert into alkene. So aqueous KOH, there is a removal of Cl from here. There is a removal of Cl from here. That is 2KCl. And there is an addition of OH take place. Just like this. Here is CS3. Now put here OH. Now put here OH. Now this one is unstable. And what will happen? There is a removal of OH, that is H2OH from here and H from here take place, and it will form you CS3CO CS3. Clear? This one is known as ketone. This is the method of preparation of aldehyde and ketone by using geminal dihalide. One more question arises here. If anyone asks you why this one is unstable product and why there is a removal of water take place, look at here. Here is lone pair of electron. There is a electronegativity difference in OH. If there is a electronegativity difference, then definitely it will move here. It will contain minus charge and it will contain plus charge. Clear to you? Now, it will try to move out here. If it try to move out here, then what will happen, friend? There is a removal of H2O take place and this electron pair will come here and will form a double bond. That is, the product is CS3COCS3. This one is ketone. So if there is more than one OH group here, then there is a tendency of removal of H2O take place to get the stable product. Due to this reason, geminal dihalide ultimately convert to ketone. Clear, friend? I'm going to rub this part and we'll discuss next question. These all are the methods related to the preparation of aldehyde and ketone. Common method. Clear? Now, next one, friend. Question number 3. Now tell me what will happen in this case. CH, triple bond CH plus H2O in presence of H2SO4 and HgSO4. Clear? Or it can be written like this, Hg2 plus or H plus. Clear? Now tell me the product. This one is acetylene and there is a hydration take place. This is a question. Now next one. If I write CS3 C triple bond CH plus H2O, then what will happen in this case? H2SO4, then HgSO4, Hg2 plus, it can be written like this. Now tell me the product. Now next one, question number 4. If I write like this, CH2 double bond CH2. Clear, friend? This method is known as reductive ozonolysis. Clear? Now what will happen in this case? If I write here CS3 CH double bond CH2 plus O3, again this one is reductive ozonolysis. Reductive ozonolysis. Now what will happen in this case? Tell me. The third part is question number 4. Wait for a moment. Next question. Question number 5. If I write here CH2, double bond CH2. Look at, listen what I'm telling. CH2 double bond CH2 plus H2O plus PdCl2, CuCl2, air or O2. Now, in each and every case, tell me the product. This is a practice session we will do during the lecture. Now tell me. This one contains triple bond. As I told you, if you do not know how to proceed the reaction, as I told you earlier, if you do not know how to proceed, if you do not know the mechanism of the reaction, just put plus and minus sign. Definitely you will get the product. What will happen? Look at. I do not know how to proceed the reaction, but I know how to put plus and minus sign. As we know, this one is water. That is the hydration process. It can be written like this, friend. H plus and OH minus. Now, this one is pi bond. It will break. Either it will move here or it will move here. If the electron pair moves here, then definitely it contains negative charge and it will contain positive charge. Now tell me what will happen. It's very simple. OH will move here and H will move here. Clear? So the product here, what will happen? Look at. That is CH2 double bond CH and put here OH. Clear? This one is vinyl alcohol. Remember, friend, this one is vinyl alcohol. As we know, that is the enol form, and there is a tautomerization take place. That is ketoenol form, but here the less number of carbon atom, it will not give ketone, it will give aldehyde. That is ketoenol form. Further, it will give you CH3CHO. Clear to you what I'm telling, friend? CH3CHO. This one is known as tautomerization. Clear? Now, if I take this one is also example of alkyne. Now, again put here H plus and OH minus. In this case, one thing I have to mention, this addition will take place via Markovnikov addition. That is, H will move on that carbon which contain more hydrogen atom. Here look at, it does not contain any hydrogen, but in CH contain one hydrogen atom. So this H will move here and this OH will move here, and the addition is Markovnikov addition when double or triple bond will break between the two carbon atom. We will not consider this carbon atom, so be careful. Now what will happen, friend? It will give you CH3. Put here C, put here OH, now double bond CH2. This one is again enol form. What I'm telling, friend, this one is again a enol form. And if there is a enolic form, now what will happen in this case? Tell me. There is a tautomerization take place. Tautomerization take place. And tautomers will give you, it will move here and double bond will shift here. That is, it gives you CH3 double bond O, then friend CH3. How the reaction proceed? I have explained this in hydrocarbon chapter, but I'm giving you a simple technique. That is OH form. What will happen? This will break, it will move here, it will contain minus charge, and OH, there is an electronegativity difference. If there is an electronegativity difference, then oxygen will acquire the electron pair, and there is only a proton, and this H will move here because it contains a negative charge, so it will form here CH3. Now there is electron pair will move here and forms a double bond, which ultimately gives you ketone. This is not a bookish mechanism. I'm just giving you a simple trick how to proceed. If you do not know the mechanism, if you do not know anything regarding any reaction, just put plus and minus sign and transfer the electron pair on that atom which has more electronegativity. This is a simple thing, and I know you all are familiar with the electronegativity of different elements, like oxygen or hydrogen. Oxygen has high electronegativity, hydrogen has less electronegativity. If I talk about chlorine, chlorine has high electronegativity. If I talk about sodium, sodium has low electronegativity. So this is a simple technique. If you do not know the mechanism, if you do not know how to proceed the reaction, just follow plus minus, just use plus minus, definitely you will get the product. But there are few exceptions. I'm not talking about the exception. Clear, friend? Now I'm going to rub this part. Now tell me what will happen in this case. Now this is a question. If it is written as CH2 double bond CH2 plus O3, reductive ozonolysis take place. Definitely, if there is a double bond, there is an addition take place, we people know. It will break like this. Either it will move here or it will move here. That is, this ozone will form an addition compound with this alkene. Now, what will happen? Look at. Here is CH2, double bond will break. Here is CH2. Oxygen, then oxygen, then oxygen. Clear? Here is oxygen put, one more oxygen, this one is ozone. Clear? Equal distribution. Now, in presence of zinc dust and water, what will happen? This bond will break equally. Like this. Look at, first part gets CH2O. CH2 can be written like this, friend, HCHO. The second part gets HCHO. That is, in this case we get 2 mole of formaldehyde. Clear to you? I have discussed the entire mechanism related to this process in chapter hydrocarbon. Again, I am repeating, I am just giving you a simple technique without following the mechanism, then also you can easily get the product. Okay, friend, now tell me what will happen in this case. So here the product, you can write here 2CHO. That is, now tell me what will happen. Again, this double bond will break because alkene show addition reaction. Now look at, if I put here CH3CH, here is CH2, clear? Oxygen here. Now put here oxygen, now put here oxygen. Further, what will happen in presence of zinc dust and H2O? What is the purpose of zinc dust? That is, it will initiate the termination of this bond. It is metallic in nature, and by presence of Zn, it will initiate the termination, the breaking of the bond. Now, how the bond will break, friend? It will break equally like this. Each part will get one oxygen each. If anyone asks you what is actual carbonyl compound, that is, if there is a CO linkage, if any molecule or organic compound contains CO linkage, then these are treated as carbonyl compound. For example, if I write it COH, this is aldehyde. If I write here RCOR, this is ketone. If I write RCOOH, this is carboxylic acid. Then this is ester.
and so on. These all are the example of carbonyl compounds. So today we are going to discuss the question from this topic. So let's start the question and say round what is given here. Question number one. Read the question carefully. An organic compound of molecular formula C3H6O. Definitely it is alkene plus O. Yes. If alkene plus O, that means to say it will define either aldehyde or ketones. Aldehydes and ketones. So, an organic compound of molecular formula C3H6O did not give silver mirror test. Okay, with tollens reagent. What is tollens reagent? Remember this? Yes. Ammonical solution of AgNO3. Ammonical solution of AgNO3 is tollens reagent. But give an oxime with hydroxyl, then definitely the answer does not contain CHO linkage. Aldehyde gives positive silver mirror test, but ketones does not. So the answer is very easy to predict, that is the answer will be ketone, the best one. C is the correct option. Now it gives an oxime, then definitely it will not be the this one is not possible. This is aldehyde and this is also not possible, aldehyde linkage. Okay, so this is the correct option, and it gives oxime with hydroxyl amine. Okay, oxime, that is CS3CO, C double bond O, CS3, then CS3, then NH2OH. This is hydroxyl amine. Okay, it gives oxime. What will happen? It can be written like this, H2NOH. There is a release of H2O take place and we get oxime. C, CS3, then double bond NOH. Clear? So for question number one, C is the correct option. Now question number two. In the Cannizzaro reaction, what is Cannizzaro reaction? Do you remember? Yes, sir. Those aldehydes which does not contain alpha hydrogen. Those aldehyde which does not contain alpha hydrogen perform Cannizzaro reaction. That is self oxidation and reduction. That is disproportionation reaction. For example, formaldehyde, for example benzaldehyde, they undergo Cannizzaro reaction. Clear? Now read the question. In alkaline medium, okay, now if I consider C6H5C double bond OH and treatment with alkali NaOH, that is OH minus. We are telling that alkaline medium. Now what will happen? First step, that is it will move here, it will contain negative sign and it will contain positive sign. So it will like this, C6H5CONA, because Na plus and OH minus, Na will move here and here put OH and H. Because it will contain positive charge, so OH will move here. Yes, this step is not a slow step. During mechanism I have discussed, because ionic reaction, a formation of ion is very easy here. So the process is very fast process. Now again, when it is treated with C6H5CHO, next mole, then what will happen, that is this will move here and this will move here. So this step is slow step because here is the involvement of molecules, and we get C6H5 C double bond O OH1 product. Is it clear to you? That is, this can be written like this. This is a benzoic acid, and so on the reaction will proceed and will get, that is, alcohol also. From benzaldehyde we get alcohol as well as benzoic acid. So the hydride, so we will say the transfer of hydride to the carbonyl group. This is the slow step. This is fast and this is slow step. Yes sir, definitely. Okay. Now the next one, question number 3, the correct structure of the product formed in the reaction. Look at here, two conditions. Okay, the double bond are between C and O, and the double bond are between C and C, and the reduction process take place, H2 gas at 1 atm in presence of palladium and carbon. Now if we consider palladium and carbon, then what will happen, this CC bond will undergo reduction more accurately, more fastly than this COO double bond. So the product, only this double bond will be converted to single bond. That is the product we get, this one. This is the product. So the answer here is B is the correct option. Question number 3, B is the correct option. Now, next question, question number 4. Consider the reaction XC2H6O. Definitely, X is formula C2H6O, alkane plus O. It may be alcohol or it may be ether as per the rule. Now when it is treated with Cu copper, we get A. We get A. This is A. Okay. We get A. Okay. Now A, when treated with tolerance reagent, ammoniacal solution of silver nitrate solution, then it gives silver, positive silver mirror test, then definitely A is aldehyde. Yes sir, if A is aldehyde, then definitely we can say this is alcohol, because when alcohol is treated with copper, oxidation take place. So the X is CH3CH2OH, oxidation we get CH3CHO. When CH3CHO undergo tolerance reagent, it gives positive silver mirror test. We got X and A. Now the next one is A when treated with NH2NHCONH2. NH2CNHCONH2, that means to say it can be written like this, CH3CH double bond O and H2N NHCONH2. What will happen, release of water molecule take place, and we get CH3CH double bond N, then NHCONH2, and this is Z. And what is Z, my friend? Z is semi-carboxide. Z is semi-carboxide. A is ethanol, X is ethanol, Y. And when it is treated with OH minus, we directly am writing, or you can write CH3CHOH, then CHCHO. Clear to you? Now further it will migrate, that is HOH release take place, that is finally we are getting CH3CH double bond C CHO. Let me check once, valency is satisfied, CH2. Okay, 1 2 1 3 and 4 2 1 3 and 4. This is butoenyl Y. So what is the product? X A is ethanol, X is ethanol, Y is butyl, and Z is semi carbazide. For question number 4, we can say that is B is the correct option. Now next one, question number 5. When a mixture of benzaldehyde and acetophenone is treated with dilute NaOH, when a mixture of benzaldehyde, what is the formula of benzaldehyde? That is C6H5CHO, this is benzaldehyde, and acetophenone, that is acetophenone formula, that is C double bond O C6H5 or C6H5 COCH3. Okay, when it is treated with dilute NaOH, then what will happen? There is a release of water molecule take place and we get the product C6H5 CH, and it can be written like this, H2CH, and there is a release of H2O take place. Okay, CH, then C6H5 CH, then double bond CH, then C double bond O and C6H5. Clear? Yes. Now what is the name of the compound? 1,3-diphenyl prop 2-in-1-one. C is the correct option. 1,3-diphenyl prop 2-in-1-one. Question number 5, mark C is the correct option. Now question number 6. Paracarazole react with chloroform in alkaline medium to give a compound A, which add hydrogen cyanide to form the compound B. The latter on hydrolysis gives chiral carboxylic acid. The structure of the carboxylic acid is paracarazole. This is OH, this is CS3, or it can also be written like this, don't worry, start from here, OH or CS3. Clear? Now when react with chloroform, CHCl3 plus NaOH in alkaline medium, what will happen in this case? This is a Riemann-Tiemann reaction. Yes, OH aldehyde group add here and CS3, this is the product, it gives the compound A. This is the compound A, which add hydrogen cyanide to form the compound B. This is the case, CS3OHCHCNO. 1,3,1,4 more compound, add on CS3CN, C, that is CN, 2,1,3,4. Now let me check one, CHOH, C double OH, that is, this can be written like this. Now O, wait for a moment, CHO will be converted, that is C double bond OH. Okay, SCN, so it will be written like this, that is CN will be converted to OH. Wait for a moment, CHOH and CN, this is the compound. Okay, now the later on hydrolysis we get the product CS3OH then CH OH then C double OH. Okay, what happened this side? This will move here, it will acquire negative sign, it will acquire positive sign, H plus and CN minus. This H will move here, that is OH, this H here CH and CN will move here. So we get, this is the product. So what is the product here? That is B is the correct option. CH